This is a Bambu Lab A1 Mini, currently my favorite 3D printer. With its compact design and a multicolor printing option, this printer is practically flawless. I already have created a few videos on it, but there is still one thing missing on this printer. Not on this printer, but the AMS system. AMS Lite works great, but there is no enclosure, so the spools are exposed to the moisture and dust. Well, I have found a solution for this, the ultimate filament spool enclosure. Let's see how it fits and works. This model is designed by Supergrapher on MakerWorld. Caught my attention because it helps to organize filament spools while keeping them protected from moisture and dust. It's a perfect for the AMS Lite system. Some of the larger enclosure parts requires a bigger print bed, so I printed them using my old 3D printer, which hasn't been turned on in a while. The PETG parts came out a bit stringy, but the parts are durable and functional, so I decided to use them rather than reprint. The smaller parts printed flawlessly on the Creality K1 and Bambu Lab A1 Mini. I used PETG and PLA materials for this project. Now here are the final printed parts. 4 main spool buckets and covers. A lot of clips to connect everything. Small buckets to hold silica gel. And front panels with a hygrometer slot. I have these square hygrometers. Let's install everything. Let's remove all 4 existing filaments and get ready to attach the enclosure. We also need to remove the rotary spool holder. Next, attach the mini funnels and air seals to the holes of the main bucket. Then connect the main bucket to the AMS system. Repeat this with other buckets. Attach this middle bracket to join the buckets and secure everything in place with the clips. Don't forget to attach the bottom clip to hold the silica bucket. The rotary spool holders fits perfectly and rotate smoothly. I recommend assembling this entire enclosure funnels, brackets, clips before attaching it to the AMS system. This method avoids the cracks, and also suggested method from the designer. Now that buckets are assembled, let's move on to the front cover. Attach the 2 front covers to the main display part using the clips. The square hygrometer fits right into the slot. Add a few silica packets to the tiny bucket and place it inside the enclosure. We have other bucket options for silica as well. Finally, attach the front cover to the bucket assembly. Lock the clips and add the number bracket on top for the extra stability. While installing the spools, remove the tiny bucket first to make a room. Let's insert all 4 spools and check the design dimensions are accurate or not. The spool fits perfectly and spins without any issue. Swapping spools is quick and easy. However, because the space between the spool is tight, you will need to remove the silica bucket when changing the spools. But that's the minor inconvenience. I am really happy with how this spool enclosure turned out. It's a practical addition to my A1 Mini setup. Lightweight, easy to set up, and it keeps the filament protected from dust and moisture. I highly recommend this design if you have an A1 or A1 Mini. It's a solid upgrade for any AMS Lite user. For more interesting 3D printing content, subscribe to 3D World and drop a comment if you have any question or suggestion. Until then, happy printing.